नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एस्पायरिंग डांसर्स, स्कॉलर्स, मेडिकल प्रैक्टिशनर्स, साइंटिस्ट्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स, लेट मी टेक दिस सब्जेक्ट मच फर्दर. इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट द इंटेलेक्ट एंड द विजडम बीइंग पिलर्स for the growth of social and civilization appreciational aspects. However, I would like to state one statement. Society must obey the truth or perish. Obey the truth or perish. Today, if I really look at the kind of practices or the kind of rituals or the kind of spiritual practices or, you know, various practices pertaining directly related, directly proportional to the development of the ecological or the society or the civilization changes. Meaning which, impacting the ecosystem, socio-economical systems, or the civilization changes happening at a rapid speed for every 100 years. Way back around it was 500 years, now 100 years, maybe even lesser than that. With the technical advancement happening in various fields, the technical know-how is increasing. The medical advancement has gone to such an extent that the human genetical changes are also taking place. Like converting male, converting to female, female converting to male, etc., etc. Various operations happening. In this kind of atmosphere, where the changes are happening on a regular day-to-day basis, I don't know if we are complying with the facts, original facts that are there in Vedas and Upanishads. I am talking about the original text. I am not talking about the texts that came after a period of time or whatever it is. I see that we are going off the track, or we are going tangential to the basic point or the focal point that Vedas and Upanishads have told. Today, if I really see the kind of deformities that an individual is facing in Western countries, I see YouTube videos wherein child as young as 7 months or 8 months or 1 year, below 1 year, suffering with the hearing impaired. Why that apathy? why that situation had come, has come, why these unwanted viruses that are affecting our ecosystem, which is directly perishing the society, perishing the individuals by way of losing their immunity, getting used to medicines, and we are tending to like use the Swadharma aspect. We are having our own self doctrines. When already one doctrine is existing, one text is existing, why are we using our own thoughts? Why are we not following that? And today, if I see whatever the old traditions were there, or were being followed, how could they survive and how we are not surviving in the 21st century? It's a very big question to be asked, ladies and gentlemen. Are we defying, or are we denying, or are we acting ignorant towards the growth factor, be it society or be it civilization? Societal development and civilization development are directly proportional to the growth or the constructive elements of the ecosystems. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. It may sound absurd, abstract. It may be an abstractive statement, but it has that practical relevance. Understand it. Because in nature, human body or the human consciousness or the human existence itself has that indigenous capability or the capacity and the tenacity and that authority to control all of these and create that balance, which we have been failing from past almost like 300 years or 400 years. It could be communal riots, it could be intellectual conflicts of interest leading to the destruction. The constructive effort of the human consciousness is going off the hook, off the track. It's going to the tangential direction, in the tangential direction. Why? Society must obey the truth. Truth here is, this is what happens. You need to follow the structure and scheme. If you are defying that, if you are not following those processes or the whatever it is, you will have to face the consequence. Not only you as a human being, you as an individual, but this is directly getting affected to the other population as well, which has been proved time and again. The ozone layer has done that effect. Now this pandemic effect. This is the beauty of Vedas and Upanishads, ladies and gentlemen. And that is one reason why medical professionals or the scientists have started looking at the Vedas and Upanishads. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. It's very important and it is vital as well. And these are the key factors and these are the key pointers for everyone in every field, specifically from the Navanidha Bhakti's point of view. You do any kind of service, good, fine. But when it comes to classical dance and classical music, it has that core value hidden in it. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. This is specifically important for the one who is in fine arts and culture. And in fact, they could be benefactors or backbone for the constructive activities or the constructive efforts to regain that balance in the ecosystem as well as socio-economic system, economical growth. Maybe yes, one may argue, how are you telling this? Yes, it has. This is what is the beauty of classical dance and music, ladies and gentlemen. Because in classical dance and music, if one practices, he or she gets that wisdom, develops that wisdom, develops that intellectual mindset in a constructive way. Because the classical dancer goes to the highest energy levels at a higher cosmic energy levels. Believe me, even it touches metaphysics, it touches kinetic theory. Most importantly, for Natya Shastra, this is one key point, and that is reason why these 108 karnas were what you call introduced. It has those values. Whatever postures or whatever mudras or whatever that we are doing, our hands itself has, you know, panchabhuta tattvas, panchakoshas. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. This is very important aspect. Believe me, if one can understand this to the core, from the conceptual point of view, and try to implement it, and generate that positive energy, believe me, there is nothing like it. There would not be any ailments or there would not be any kind of calamities in this universe. Thus, I conclude this video with the pointers to take a note on understanding the practical importance of the mudras in cross reference to panchabhutas or panchakoshas that activate, get activated and generate that positive energy. I'm not trying to get into the argumentative aspect, or I'm not trying to tell you that this is what is the thing, but this could be one factor that could even stop this these calamities. No, but then we could try. There is no harm in it, right? In creating that ecological balance, at least. Maybe yes, scientifically there could not be any reference, but yes, if we try and if we put it across, definitely yes, things may work out. Ladies and gentlemen, understand this. This is what is the practical importance, and this is where things happen. There is no harm in trying. Generating that positive energy and trying to create that balance in the ecosystem, or the socio-economic balancing act, or the civilization act. Maybe we could create that spiritual and the spiritual renaissance, or a ritualistic renaissance, which could be a constructive effort to create that awareness. If not today, maybe over a period of time. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. Thus, I conclude this video with the pointers to the aspiring dancers or the musicologists or the medical practitioners or the scientists in various domains to have this viewpoint as well. Start thinking, fine arts and culture from this point of view in the eco-balancing act system. However, but understand this statement. Society must try to obey the truth, or you will perish. It has a very wider meaning, ladies and gentlemen. Understand this. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive. Let's try understanding the evolution of life in cross reference to the manifestation of the mental power. If we really look at mental power, from where does it exist? What is this mental power? When I say mental power, it is again dependent on how you control your restlessness in your mind, turbulences, and that obstinacy nature that prevails in an individual or as a person, which is unique by its own nature. When I say nature, it is again dependent on the environmental conditions, socio-economical conditions, social conditions, and the intellectual conditions. Why am I talking about this at this stage is that most of us think bhakti or the devotion, this devotional aspect has that key role, which again gets manifested, taking control over the five koshas or the kleshas or the five epithetic conditions, which can also be told as or termed as factors or cofactors governing this power, which is again the vital part of the human existence nature as a whole. Because crux of the subject or the objective behind doing whole of this is to take control and trying to be adaptive so that he or she can use his or mind in a constructive aspect of the human development. Today, the ecosystem or the universal nature balance depends on how best are you trying to take control and how best you are trying to use the same. Because most of the natural disasters or most of the actions or reactions happening in the from the ecosystem, ecological system or the universe system is due to the fact that we as an individual are failing to understand the limitations, which was what emphasized by Ramakrishna Paramahamsa and Swami Vivekananda as such. They could take control over everything and they could actually try to talk about it. And they could try to do the same. And in fact, Shankaracharya or Madhvacharya, if they had established any kind of dharma or adharma concepts in the form of doctrines for one person's growth at an epicenter level towards the betterment of the society as well as human being himself or herself, is to make sure that this ecosystem or social economic system or civilization system or the society system falls in place. Though one may argue that this is not important, but for the ecosystem to come to a balanced state, one needs to understand these concepts in depth and in the deeper aspects. As I come and as I speak in whole of my videos, I emphasize on Navanidha Bhaktis, of which one of the easiest is art and cultural forms. Fine arts play a key role in this, because in fine arts we tend to take a situation and present that which gives a moral and which gives the punchline, helping the society to understand. That is one reason why the evolution of the life as a whole is the manifestation of mental power. Once he or she tries to understand the basic conceptual understanding or the objective of following the rules or obeying the rules and regulations laid down as per philosophical approach or the spiritual approach, that's where lies the controlling of man mental power or the manpower as a whole. Even getting to mental power, one needs to understand what are the limitations of a human being. Can it be used to a larger extent? As Swami Vivekananda says, our human brain has the capacity of using it to the core and to the best possible extent, to 100%, even 100+% kind of thing. Very few scientists could use that, of which Albert Einstein, Graham Bell, Edison, these were a few scientists, exceptional scientists, who experimented on the same. Darth is a situation today that we do not have people like this. It's a very serious question. It is a very emergency situation that one needs to really look at or question himself or herself to really understand this. They could understand the evolutionary system of the life to the deeper aspect at the highest level. This needs to be understood. Ladies and gentlemen, today the ecosystem or the socio-economic system or the society changes system, whatever be it, if it is not falling in a schematic way or the systematic way, it's only due to the failure of understanding how to manifest this mental power within us. The mental power, again, has that immense capacity, the tenacity, and the kind of strength that the mental power has, nobody knows. We are not able to use that, unfortunately. Our ecosystem is repriving back only for a simple reason, that we have been using this mental power for something which does not have any meaning. we have been using this mental power for something which does not make any sense, and we have been acting insane. Though we are sane, we are having that knowledge, we develop that knowledge. Ladies and gentlemen, understand this. The pointers or the cofactors or the factors for the individual to understand from this video is, how do you create or how do you understand the evolution of life in cross reference to manifestation of the mental power within us? Let's try unleashing this. Then we can find that, you know, ecosystem's balance, this balancing act has to be understood from this. Once we try to understand evolution of life in cross reference to manifestation of the mental power within us, believe me, whatever apathies or whatever that is happening today in this universe will not really happen if we try to understand to the core in the deeper and in-depth aspect.
Talking about emotions, moods, and various aspects of the common structural phenomena that affects our body, mind, and soul, taking the individual to a level where he or she gets to understand about real and unreal, or sat or asat, or you can say it could be like a spiritual communion of Prakriti and Purusha from the Vedic point of view. From the scientific point of view, the universe and the creator. Now, today, if I really look at the very much complex application of mind as such, with the emerging technologies happening from the scientific front, from the medical front, from various corners, from 360 degrees point of view, if we really look at it, our neuroscience has increased its width from the psychodermic point of view and psychic point of view, taking the subject into educational psychology, molecular psychiatry, molecular neurodegeneration, brain behavior and immunity. If we really see, if we engulf all of this, the human psyche as such has never changed at all. It had its own theory planted. Unfortunately, today in our modern day scientists, are coming up with their theories. But logically speaking, if you see, this has already been told 10,000 years back, 15,000 years back, as such. The point is, maybe I could be wrong with my perception, or I could be like trying to, you know, take the subject off the track, but I feel that today the neuroscience or the psychiatry domain or the psychology domain or the modern day neuroscience generation or the immunity factor has been taking a beat as such. Only for a simple reason that we had various scientists from mythology era or prehistoric era, right from Indic culture, Indus Valley civilization, Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, various civilizations and various social societal changes have had happened, and it has been changing from a long period, almost like 10,000 or 15,000 years back. If we really look at all of these existed, whatever that we are doing, it is just that we are churning out the subject. In fact, we are recycling the subject as such. The scientific study is advancing in itself. The only difference is that we had what you call palm leaves or something like that. Even before palm leaves came, it was verbal communication. Even before verbal communication, it was the systematized study of figurative language. Before figurative language, it was sounds. That is where actually the science of sounds come into picture. So I would not be really astonished or shocked to get into this kind of thing, where modern day scientists are comparing whatever neuroscience or whatever science, the emerging science or the emerging changes, structural changes or the structural schematic changes happening, in cross reference to Vedas and Upanishads. In fact, if you really see the Vedic chantings, whatever that are done, has all of these elements. The kind of molecular or atomic changes or the cellular changes that happen due to listening to all of these Vedic chantings or Upanishads chantings, or hearing to the Sanskrit words every now and then, becoming a consistent practice, this is where the immunity factor comes into picture. Unfortunately, we are not knowing that. Unknowingly, most of the individuals do that by getting into that subject. And this is where the practical importance of dance and music comes into picture, be it any kind of genre. Any kind of genre, believe me. It could be classical, it could be semi-classical, it could be folklore, it could be Western, it could be from Western, ballerina, ballet, dance ballet. From any kind of race. And here is where one needs to understand from where those roots come. How do you think? And what you think about it? The brain and behavior pattern is again dependent on the immunity factor, which one needs to understand. And the immunity of the body starts happening once you make your body flexible and try to use that to the best possible extent. 100%. You have to use it to the 100% level, which only very few scientists could use, like Albert Einstein or Alexander Graham Bell or Edison or late and legendary personality, Kalam sir, Sarvepalli Radhakrishna. The point is, this brain and behavior pattern are the key for your structured way of thinking. That thought process. And this is where the neuroscience plays a key role. Of late, I have been hearing about the artificial intelligence, like robotics coming into picture and robotics taking over the natural intelligence. Now the point is, once robotics come into picture or whatever this artificial intelligence comes into picture, the thinking process, the thought process will start diminishing. When I say diminishing, It wouldn't really go the way it has to. It is indeed a very big challenge for modern day scientists, specifically for the scholars and research scholars from the art and culture fraternity, because art and culture is not stipulated to the entertainment aspect. If we see, And art and culture has the influence on the brain behavior. And furthermore, it goes to the educational perspective as well. That's where the intellectual thinking starts happening. It goes to the highest level. Mind you, this is what makes or takes an individual to the highest level. The point is, is the prehistoric period the fully developed scientific advanced study domain, or the 21st century fully developed scientific advanced domain? It's a $1,000 billion question, ladies and gentlemen, dancers, musicologists, psychologists from medical domain, scholars and research scholars from both the domains, medical domain as well as art and culture domain, music domain, scientific domain, astrophysics domain. It's a $1,000 billion question. We are in a very such ambiguous state now. We are not able to understand as such. What is it that really is disturbing? Have we ever thought about it? The changing educational trends, thinking of the psychology, getting into the molecular or the biotechnological advancement of the psychology part, from the atomic point of view, atom point of view, understanding the subject from the atom and subatomic levels point of view. This is the beauty of Vedas and Upanishads, ladies and gentlemen. And this is the beauty of Shastras as such. Most of us think Natya Shastra is all about the structured application of dance or the ways of thinking or whatever it is. But if you get into the deep subject of it, it is touching upon molecular psychiatry, atomic psychiatry, subatomic psychiatry, molecular regeneration, molecular neuro regeneration, and the educational psychology as well, and the brain and behavior factors. See, such a beauty of the subject. What we did was, I would rather say, what the prehistoric seers did was, with their own convenience, for their own convenience, they added and deleted certain topics. which unfortunately not everyone is able to get into. But logically, if you see, Natyashastra had various versions, and predominantly there was only one that came out, that was Bharata's Natyashastra, which is speaking about the various aspects of the structured and logical approach towards the classical dance as such. But if you see, Natyashastra had these four domains, that is educational psychology, molecular psychiatry, molecular neurodegeneration factors, molecular neurogeneration, neuropsychiatry, psychotic way of thinking, the human psyche to the core, to understand the practical importance of how exactly the human intellect can think to the deeper level. If we get into 108 karanas, which will be my next topic, which I will be talking about in detail. And it talks about brain behavior and immunity. Ladies and gentlemen, please understand, Natyashastra is not only the text for dancers for a systematic approach towards becoming a better dancer by understanding that subject, but it has the practical importance of the scientific study, the medical study involving brain behavior and immunity, and the molecular neurosciences, both from generating and degenerating factors, and from the psyche point of view, from the psychiatry point of view as well, and from the educational point of view as well, both from spiritual perspective, spiritual or philosophical perspective, or the individual perspective. Understand, this is the beauty of the subject. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note. Natyashastra is not only the doctrine or the text or the guide for dancers, but it has primarily the study of brain behavior patterns, brain patterns, neuroscience patterns, and immunity factors, molecular neurogenerations, molecular neurological degenerating factors, atomic level factors, subatomic creation of the universe factors as an individual. Thus, I conclude this video. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Have a nice day ahead.